And you know what I say when people are when they're trying to objection handle another thing, sort of in that same vein, right? Is I say follow the no,
Okay.
right? So follow the no. So if you're speaking to somebody on the other line, and they're like, oh, well, I have a realtor friend, right, that I'd probably list with, and you're like, oh, okay, yeah, I understand, okay. And so when you do sell your home, where are you going to be moving to next? Yada yada yada. I'm like, hold on, well, stop. At the end of this conversation, when they say no to you, why will they be saying no to you?
Because he didn't bring value.
Because they have a realtor friend they're going to list with, and you didn't go after that, right? You just glossed over it. That was your no. They're just going to give it back to you. You forgot about that. Dial it back. Go to that one. Chase that rabbit down, right?
Okay, well, let's role play that out so people actually can see that take place. So, Matt, be your very unsavory self. Dale, be the caller. And let's see how this goes. Scene.
Okay. All right. So we're just going to make it. We're gonna fast forward to this. Hey,
Okay.
Matt. So just wanted to find out if you're interested in putting your home back on the market.
Oh man, I've been thinking about it. My wife's cousin's former dock walker's uncle is a he's an agent here in the area, and he's probably who we'd list with if we go with that direction.
Oh, great. Okay, so your uncle's cousin's former dog walker. I might have messed that up a little bit. I'm not sure, but anyway, so that's the agent that you think you'd be using.
Yeah, probably.
Okay, great. Was there a reason that you didn't use him in the first place?
My wife's cousin herself is an agent. Now, it turns out she was new, and we weren't crazy about what she did to market the property, but yeah, we did give her a shot first.
Okay, gave her a shot first, and now so you'd like to move over to another person that you know through your channels.
Right.
Got it. Okay. So it seems like it's more comfortable to you to work through people that you already know. Is that correct?
Yeah, it's I don't leave the house much, and it's really important to me to work with someone that I trust, someone that's in the family, someone that's in my social network. Yeah.
Got it. Got it. So trust is really important to you in an agent. What else is really important to you in an agent?
I guess it comes back to trust, but this is someone that we're opening up my home to, and I mean it needs to be someone that can navigate the stacks of magazines and newspapers that are very precious to me. And I mean so I really need someone that kind of understands my situation and enjoys like taking a look at my superhero action figure collection in between showings and things like that. So yeah, those things are really important to me. Oh, okay.
I'll be hanging up. No, so what I'm doing here is, right, instead of just glossing over that you have somebody or making you wrong for wanting to work with them, right? I'm going to go down the you just opened a rabbit hole, which is my no, and I'm going to go into it with you. I'm going to find out what your experience is of that, what you know. I'm going to find out what process you think you're going to follow, which is stick with somebody I know. Hire an agent that's family or friend, and then what outcome do you think you're going to get from that, right? Which means I'm going to sell my home and feel good about it. I can trust the people that I work with. I don't have to worry about this agent that I've hired. So I'm going to understand your experience, process, and outcome. And then once we get that out and I'm on the same side of the table with you, I'm going to say, oh, great. Well, what if we used a slightly different process? And I could get you even more, better, faster, cheaper, or easier of whatever this outcome is that you want.